You're watching the IT Taster channel, and in this video I'm going to show you how to add an additional domain controller to an existing domain in Microsoft Windows Server 2019. We'll start off by discussing a few reasons why that's a good idea, and then we'll go over to the lab and we'll take a look at the setup and configuration process. Before we get started, don't forget to give the video a like and subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already. I'm also around on social media too, and I'll leave the links below in the description. So with that said, let's get started. One big advantage of a client-server network is centralized management. In a Windows Server network, this is provided by domain controllers, DCs that are configured to run the Active Directory domain services role. Domain controllers perform a number of important functions, including dealing with logins, and authenticating network users. But having a single domain controller like this is a single point of failure. If the domain controller fails, we're no longer able to authenticate users or access important network resources. So it's considered good practice to have more than one domain controller. Additional domain controllers are able to continue to process user logins and also provide those all important network services. The failed domain controller can be repaired, minimizing disruption for the network users. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to add an additional domain controller to an existing domain. Now, the process that we're going to follow involves joining the server to the domain, installing the Active Directory domain services role, and adding the additional domain controller to the existing domain. The lab setup consists of a Windows Server 2019 domain controller called Server 1 that we can see on the left. Its IP address is 192.168.1.101. Server 1 is also running the DNS role, and the domain is called training.ittaster.com. Now, we also have a standalone server, Server 2, over on the right hand side that I'm going to join to the domain training.ittaster.com. I'll install the Active Directory domain services role and configure Server 2 to be an additional domain controller. Now, you may want to take a screenshot of the IP address configuration here to make the video easier to follow along with. Now, before we begin, it's important to keep in mind that I'm working within a test lab environment, which is a great place for learning and experimentation, not a production network. So let's go over to the lab and get started. I've logged into my server and I'm in Server Manager. Now, this server is my domain controller, it's Server 1, and the domain is training.ittaster.com. We can see the IP address 192.168.1.101. If I click Dashboard, we can see the roles that are installed on the server. We have Active Directory domain services, which we would expect for a DC. And this is also my DNS server as well. It's running the DNS server role. I'm going to click Tools and go to Active Directory Users and Computers and expand the domain training.ittaster.com. And we can see some additional organizational units that I've added, things like sales computers, sales users. If I click on training computers, it's populated with my stations 1 to 4. And if I click on training users, we have some users there and also some groups. Now, the reason I'm showing you this is when we come to install our additional domain controller, the two domain controllers will replicate. They'll replicate their Active Directory databases, and our new domain controller should be populated with all of the information that we see here, our objects such as computers and users and groups, etc. So I'm going to switch over now to Server 2 so we can get started. Okay, I'm logged into my second server and I'm in Server Manager. We can see that it has the file and storage services role installed, which is installed by default. And if I click local server, we can see the server's name, Server 2, and that it belongs to a work group called Work Group. And the server's IP address, 192.168.1.102. Now, before we can make this server a domain controller, we need to join the domain first. Now, one thing that's really important whenever you're joining a computer or a server to a domain, we need to be able to resolve the domain name using DNS. So I'm going to click my IP address. I'm going to go to my IP address settings, and I'm going to check my DNS server IP address. Now, at the moment, it's pointing to 192.168.1.254. Now, that's my router. Now, you'll remember my domain controller server 1 is running the DNS server role. That's my DNS server. So I'm going to change this to 192.168.1.101. And the next thing I'm going to do, just close that down, and I'm going to go to a command prompt. I'm just going to perform an NS lookup just to make sure that I can resolve my server's host name, my domain controller. So I'm going to type NS lookup server1.training.ittaster.com. And we can see the DNS server resolves the hostname server1.training.ittaster.com. So we're all good to go. So we'll just close that down. The next thing I'm going to do is click on Workgroup, click Change, click Domain, and I'm going to enter the domain name training.ittaster.com. That's the domain we want to join. Click OK. I'm going to specify the domain administrator account, which is training/administrator. Now, the reason we enter training/administrator is so that the computer doesn't get confused with the server's local administrator account. Training/administrator is the domain administrator account for the domain. I'm going to enter the password and click OK. We get the message, welcome to the training.ittaster.com domain. So click OK. And we're reminded that we must restart the computer to apply these changes. So I'm going to click OK, close that, and restart the server. The server's restarted, so I'm going to log back in now. And notice I'm using the domain administrator account this time. It's going to take a little while just to create the domain administrator account profile, so I'm going to skip forward a little bit. Okay, we're now in Server Manager. I'm just going to hide this tile. And if I click on Local Server, we can now see that Server 2 is a member of the domain training.ittaster.com. So we've successfully joined the domain. Now, the next thing I want to do is install the Active Directory Domain Services role. So to do that, I need to click Manage, Add Roles and Features, click Next on the first page of the wizard. I'm going to perform a role-based or feature-based installation and click Next. Now, I've only got the one server added to my server pool here, but if we have multiple servers, we simply need to select the appropriate server here. So I'm going to go with the default server 2, which is my only server, and click Next. I need to click Active Directory Domain Services, select that. Click Add Additional Features. I don't need to do anything extra here, just click Next. Again, I can accept the defaults on this screen. Now, one little tip I would give you, whenever you are adding roles and features, always just double check the destination server up here, because if you are working with multiple servers, it's a good way of just making sure you're installing the correct role on the correct server. Click Next. Now, this screen reminds us that to help ensure users are able to log on and give us that little bit of extra resilience, install a minimum of 2 domain controllers for a domain. which is useful advice, and click Next. And click Install. Now again, this is going to take a little while, so I'm going to let the installation run through and we'll pick the video back up again when this process is complete. The installation process is now complete and I need to click on Promote this server to a domain controller. We need to select the deployment operation, and you'll see the first option on the list, which is selected by default, is to add a domain controller to an existing domain, which is what we want to do. We can see the domain name training.ittaster.com is automatically populated, and we can also see the account which we are going to use to perform this operation, which is our training administrator account. And I just need to click Next. We need to specify the domain controller capabilities. We can see that DNS is ticked by default and also global catalog. Now, I want a second DNS server, that's good for resilience, and also a second global catalog server as well. I now need to specify a directory services restore mode password, so I'm going to do that. And click Next. On the DNS options screen, I just need to click Next. I don't need to specify any additional replication options. Replicating from any domain controller is fine in this scenario. So I'll click Next. Here we have the option to specify the location of the Active Directory Domain Services database, log files folder, and sysfol folder. I'm going to keep the defaults and click Next. I need to review my selections. And when I'm happy with that, just click Next. The server is now going to perform a prerequisites check. As you can see, all prerequisite checks have passed successfully, so I can click Install. Now this process is going to take a little while, so again I'll rejoin the video when it's completed. The installation process is finished, the server's restarted, I've logged back in and I'm back in Server Manager on Server 2. If I click Dashboard, we can now see that we have the Active Directory Domain Services role installed, as well as DNS. If I go to Tools and open up Active Directory Users and Computers, if I expand my domain training.ittaster.com, we can see my organizational units. If I click Domain Controllers, you can see we now have two domain controllers, Server 1 and Server 2. And also my additional organizational units that I added. If I click Training Computers, we can now see my workstations, stations 1 to 4. And if I click Training Users, we can see my users and also the security groups as well. So this shows us that the domain controllers have replicated. So I've successfully added an additional domain controller to my domain. Well, that brings us to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you found it helpful, and hopefully it's also inspired you to try this out in your own learning labs. Don't forget to give the video a like and leave a comment below. And also don't forget to subscribe to the IT Taster channel to receive alerts of new content. So as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.